Infectious disease experts have cast doubt on the 5-kilometre rule, saying it has little benefit. Victoria's recorded 10 new cases as the Premier clarified some of the grey areas around Step 2. Here's Dougal Beattie.
Masks have become a feature of life in Melbourne, and today even our trams were adapting. There were 10 new cases in Victoria, 3 are linked to known outbreaks, while 7 are under investigation. Sadly, the death toll rose to 794, with 7 more deaths. Active cases keep falling, down 33 to 326, and the Melbourne rolling average has dipped below 20 to 18.2.
That should lead to a sense of confidence and optimism that we've took a substantial step on Sunday, and we're well placed to take an even more substantial step towards that COVID normal.
And today, a clarification from the Premier about what's now allowed under Step 2. There is no 5-kilometre limit for weddings, but Melburnians can't travel to regional Victoria to attend a ceremony. Parents can cross the metro border for childcare, but are still subject to Step 2 restrictions. All swimming pools in apartment buildings are off limits. Dog groomers are only allowed to work in retail stores. Tradies are allowed in homes, but only for emergency repairs. And learner drivers can practice driving if they're out for essential travel. Cricket nets have also been given the all clear, while tennis courts are still a no-go.
I think it'll be a feature of some nets in the park. There's an issue about shared equipment.
The new suburban hubs and IT system are close to being rolled out to improve Victoria's malign contact tracing.
If there is an outbreak, as there will be under a suppression strategy, that we will have the best system in place.
And as cases come down, infectious disease experts have questioned the effectiveness of keeping the 5-kilometre restrictions.
Providing that stays that way, the 5-kilometre rule will probably have marginal extra benefit.
Movement means virus. It's as simple as that.
Dougal Beattie's at Treasury Place. Dougal, there's been a small cabinet shake-up.
The reshuffle was to fill the vacancy left by former Health Minister Jenny Markakos. Labor MP Ingrid Stitt was this afternoon sworn in virtually by the Governor. She now joins the Cabinet as the new Workplace Safety Minister. James Molino takes on the role of Mental Health Minister in addition to Education. And Danny Pearson becomes the new Minister for Creative Industry. Pete, this is now the second Cabinet reshuffle in 3 months for the Andrews Government.
Dougal Beattie reporting.